niemy, może.
Some bloke came up to me and he said, I'm a
when I'm cleaning windows.
He winked his arsehole in and out. He made his balls inflate.
So they
resemble the giant globes that stand at the garden gate.
Yeah, what have you had in your hand?
Oh, you are awful.
But I like you.
John Thomas Alcock, he had gigantic genitalia. He lived next door to mother. Then he buggered off to Australia. And 9 months later, I was born. And the midwife upped and said, shall I tie a knot in his belly button cord or else in this instead? I never ever looked like father. I scarcely ever looked like ma. And I was an outcast in my home. Everybody say ah.
Ah.
London, New York, Paris, Wigan. Everybody talk about either biggin.
I wandered lonely as a clod where folks could never find me, with several yards of pork clarinet trailing on the ground behind me. But then in a gent's urinal in 1979, I caught a glimpse of a donga with a birthmark just like mine. Alcock's the name, its owner said, but you can call me John. Remember me to mother? I said, fuck me, I'm the son of the man with the biggest plonker in the world. He keeps it in his trousers tightly curled. It's a yard and a half if it's an inch, and it's more when it's unfurled. Oh, wow, he's the man with the biggest plonker in the world. John Thomas Alcock, he had a 5'7" and I've inherited 5'6" and balls like a Doberman Pinscher. Though I don't look like daddy or the milkman or the lodger, I can match John Thomas in dimensions of the nodger. And like my pop before me, when dirty deeds are done, the girls line up each morning for the rising of the sun of the man with the biggest plonker in the world. He keeps it in his trousers tightly curled. It's a yard and a half if it's an inch, and it's more when it's unfurled. Oh, wow, he's the man with the biggest plonker in the world. I really am the lady's treat, 'cause though I only have two hands, I usually swing several feet. I'm following father's footsteps down the path that he once trod. I have outstanding trousers and a job with Dino Rod. Impressions of an elephant? Watch me pick up that bun. They call me Ivor Biggin, but really I'm the son of the man with the biggest plonker in the world. He keeps it in his trousers tightly curled. It's a yard and a half if it's an inch, and it's more when it's unfurled. Oh, well, he's the man with the biggest plonker in the world. John Thomas Alcock, he died, he did, and it seems to me that all what I inherited is slapping down below my knee. But still I see him in my dreams with trousers chock-a-block, pole vaulting around his bedroom and tripping over his cock. In his last willy and testicle, he said, my race is run. But girls, beware of that twat there who reckons he's the son of the man with the biggest plonker in the world. He keeps it in his trousers tightly curled. It's a yard and a half if it's an inch, and it's more when it's unfurled. Oh, well, he's the man with the biggest plonker in the world.